Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in an authentic hadith narrated by Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, and this hadith is narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, where he says, "Ma min da'watin afdalu an yaqul." There isn't a dua better than the one that you say, "Allahumma inni." So I'll say it a little slow, so if you want to repeat or memorize it, then you're welcome to do so. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-mu'afata fi dunya wal-akhirah. That's it. That's the first dua, insha'Allah ta'ala. You're asking Allah Azza wa Jal, "Oh Allah, indeed I ask you for al-mu'afata in this world and in the akhirah." Now, the whole conversation revolves around what is the meaning of this beautiful word, al-mu'afata. Mu'afata literally means recovery, or somebody who's on the path of getting good health and strength and starting to recover from whatever pain or struggle they're going through. Now, what you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in this dua is you're asking Allah for stability in life. So al-mu'afata is not necessarily restricted to just overall good health, although that's one of the most important things that we will ever have in this world. But it also talks to us about just overall the ability to cope with and to understand and to deal with everything that we find in this world that tends to make life somewhat difficult in whatever way, shape or form. So al-mu'afata is you are asking Allah anything that you have to confront in this world, that you want to be able to do that with the best of health and strength. And even if you happen to go through a situation and you go through it with some sort of pain or struggle, then you want to be able to recover from that. Let me give you an example. Right now, these days, because of COVID and the whole lockdown scenario, depression, domestic issues, just overall emotional struggle, all of these things are on the rise. And governments across the globe, especially in this part of the world, in the West where we are, governments are putting in millions and millions of dollars trying to just get the resources out there so that people feel like they get some support as they're going through whatever problems they're going through. This dua is one of those resources. You are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to at least help you get through some of these difficult times. Because why? All of us are going to feel the pain. We're all going to feel the brunt of this lockdown. And it looks like at least for a couple of years, life is not going to go back the way it used to. And it's going to take some time before we get there again, insha'Allah ta'ala. So in the meantime, psychologically and mentally and emotionally, people are struggling. And every day, I will see an email, I will get a text, I will see something online that somebody is struggling in some way mentally and emotionally. And whether it's related to the lockdown or they're having marital issues, but there's no help, they can't go for counseling anywhere, everywhere is shut down, they can't go to the masajids, they can't book appointments, none of these things are available. And so the depression rate starts to rise psychologically, like they just don't know how to cope with this stuff. And so one thing that I want to offer everyone, insha'Allah ta'ala, is this beautiful dua. Is that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the ability to recover and to maintain some sense of stability, both mentally, emotionally, physically, in all forms in this world. But then this dua also says, وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ, and the hereafter. Why? Because when we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we get put on trial, we are asking Allah al-mu'afata to give us the ability to recover from that moment that Allah Azza wa Jal describes in the Quran, in actually in Surah Al-Qiyamah, that as the believer is called out to come for judgment, that their limbs will start to separate and dislocate from their bodies. Why? Because out of fear that they're going to now confront Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the moment has finally come. All the months and the years that Allah gave you in this world, it all came down to that moment. Everything that you've said and done, it boils down to that moment. So when they are called out, Ya Fulan ibn Fulan, O son of so and so, or daughter of so and so, come to the accountability or to the trial or to the hisab of your creator. And then the questioning begins. So that fear is just something that is going to be there for everyone. But then there's also that possibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give strength to certain individuals who were close to Him, who talked to Him, who made dua to Him, who prayed to Him, who tried to follow all of His commands as best as they could. And this dua helps us to do that. So in the akhirah, we also want the ability to recover and we want some sense of stability as we get through a day that is equivalent to 50,000 years. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us strength. Allahumma ameen. Let's go on to the next dua. Next dua is a little bit longer, but it's a dua you all know. Now listen to it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to say, Allahumma aslih li deenan alladhi huwa ismatu amri. وأصلح لي دنياي التي فيها معاشي وأصلح لي آخرتنا التي إليها معادي واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا لكل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. Again, this dua is mentioned in Bukhari and Muslim, and the hadith are many. Many companions narrated that the Prophet ﷺ used to say this dua. Now just keep in mind, you're going to hear a lot of hadith that mention the Prophet ﷺ used to say, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ يَقُولُ. And it'll just sound very generic that he used to say, he used to say, he used to say. You know, one can come to the conclusion that, well, he used to say a lot of du'as, it looks like. So how come these companions narrate certain du'as and it just sounds like they may have excluded others? When it says the hadith, when it starts off and it says, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, he used to say, it means that they heard him say these du'as more so than others. So they, when he used to say, meaning we used to hear him say this a lot. He used to recite this during the days and the nights in his du'as. These were du'as, in his prayers. These are du'as that he used to repeat and they were very repetitive for him. He used to recite them a lot, like he depended on them for something. There was something special and unique about them. So the second dua, listen to it. Allahumma aslih li deenan alladhi huwa ismatu amri. O Allah, make the source that keeps me stable and corrects my life and keeps me protected in this world, make it my religion. So aslih li deen, aslih, you're asking for some sense of a stability and the ability to rectify your affairs through your deen. So the first thing you're asking Allah in this dua is, O Allah, allow my religion to be the source that resolves all of my problems, that gives me all of the protection, that provides me all direction and guidance and solutions in my life. وأصلح, so اللهم أصلح لدينا الذي هو عصمة أمري. That's the first part. وأصلح لنا دنياي التي فيها معاشي. And also protect and purify and give me stability in the world in which I live in. التي فيها معاشي. This is the world that we live in and we reside in. You know, معاشي comes from the word عاشا. And عاشا means that you find comfort in a place, but you don't depend on it. So as long as you're there, you try to make the most of it. So you enjoy it, but you never get addicted to it. You never get attached to it. So it's really interesting that out of all the words the Prophet ﷺ uses to describe living in this world, that ma'ashi is the one that's being called out. وَأَصْلِحْ لَنَا or وَأَصْلِحْ لِآخِرَتَنَا الَّتِي إِلَيْهَا مَعَادُنَا or ma'adi. So you're also asking, O Allah, make it easy for me, the path that leads me towards the hereafter, because that's where we're all going. التي فيها معادي أو التي إليها معادي. The place in which ultimately I'm going to return to. So we're going to leave this world, of course, and go back to that life. Go back to an afterlife. وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي فيها أو إليها معادي. واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا لكل خير. So you're asking, oh Allah, allow me that my life in this world becomes ziyadatan li likulli khayr, that it becomes something that increases me in every good, in every possible way, every single way possible. Allow my life in this world to increase me for the better. So you're basically asking Allah, oh Allah, give me the ability that as long as I'm here, that I constantly uplift and I do the right things. I do righteous deeds. I make the right decisions. I just live in accordance to a manner that's pleasing to you. So وَجْعَلِ الْحَيَاةَ زِيَادَةً لِي لِكُلِّ خَيْرٍ وَجْعَلِ الْمَوْتَ رَاحَةً لِي مِن كُلِّ شَرٍ, and also make my death far away from the things that are despicable, that are things that are difficult, the things that are hard for me. Sharran is just things that, you know, they're hard to look at. They're hard to look at, and you just don't want anything to do that. You want sharrun to be as far away from you as possible. So وَجَعَلِ الْمَوْتَ رَاحَةً لِي مِنْ كُلِّ شَرٍ. So allow all the difficulties, all the pain and the struggle that's associated with death to be far away from me. This dua, it almost feels like if we just had one dua to make, it would probably have been this one. It captured everything. It captured the worldly life, then it went to the akhirah, then it went to life, and then it went into death. It just captured everything. And this dua is one of the best du'as that a believer can make. And so I'm sure a lot of you listening to this, you've heard this du'a somewhere. Imams love to recite these du'as. There's a good chance that every du'a qunut that you listen to from Mecca or Medina, the imam after Taraweeh, when he's leading the witr prayer, he's going to make his du'a al-qunut. There's almost every single imam at some point will make this dua. It's become like a standard dua that the believer should have and should make. So try to get your hands on this dua. You literally just go to Google and type in Allahumma. You can type it in literally transliteration form. And if you're comfortable with Arabic, just type in Allahumma aslih li dini. Allahumma aslih li dini. In transliteration, just literally write out the words Allahumma aslih li dini. For those of you who would like to gain the ajr, if you want to just capture that dua and just put it in the comments field so others can at least cut and paste it, by all means, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with that. So these are the two du'as, insha'Allah ta'ala, that I wanted to share with you. As you can see from the title of this video, of one of the best du'as ever, simply because the previous dua, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam literally says that there is not a dua that is better than this dua, al-mu'afata, giving you the ability to gain stability and to recover from the struggles of this world and in the akhirah. And of course, the second beautiful dua that we conclude with, it's a long dua, but very easy to memorize and so complete in every possible way. Captures everything about the worldly life, everything about the afterlife, everything about life in general, and everything about death. All of it captured beautifully in this dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your du'as. And if you are using these du'as in your prayers, may Allah azza wa jal increase you with it and accept it from you. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and protect your health and strength aynama kan, wherever you are. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allahu khayran, and let us stay tuned, insha'Allah ta'ala, for tomorrow for episode number 4. Remember, we will have about 10 episodes of prophetic du'as. So keep up with it. And alhamdulillah, for those of you that keep asking me, alhamdulillah, finally my YouTube channel is updated. So all the previous episodes, the previous titles, the previous series that we've done, all of that stuff now, alhamdulillah, is completely updated 100%. on my YouTube channel. So you're welcome to go there. If you want to retract, if you want to listen to something over again, or you simply first time coming, listening to some of the things that we're talking about, you're welcome to go back. Just go to the YouTube channel. Just type in my name, Muslih Khan. You'll see it come up there. And you'll see in the playlist, you'll see all the topics. There is something there for everyone in the family, all ages. Inshallah, I'm sure you'll find something that could be meaningful and uplifting for you and your family. So I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes that easy for you. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan, everybody. May Allah azza wa jal keep you safe and healthy wherever you are. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.